Okay, so guys, heads up. First off, this is a heads up, all points bulletin emergency video. So wait to watch to the end because I'm giving you guys a mission and bleed it into the black pills and fuck up their streams. I don't care anymore. Anyway, talking about scorched earth. Scorched earth is a defensive policy and a retreat policy that countries, cities, people, companies go into after when they realize they're getting their asses kicked, and they set fire to everything on the way out the door. The Russians did that. The Soviets did that. As the Germans came into Russia, Ukraine, etc. in 1942 and 1941, and you know, this is a policy that ancient history is full of scorched earth. Now, is it something I approve of? No, because people that are left over have nothing. Okay, because you're not bringing everybody with you. No matter how hard you try to convince them, there are people there that won't leave their house. They won't leave their homes. So, you know, scorched earth in literal wartime hurts everybody. Okay, so let's talk about scorched earth and companies. If you know the end is nigh, and you know there's a better idea coming, what do you do? You set fire to everything you can that leads into something good on the way out the door. And guess what? That's what's happening. I'm going to call them out right now. WW Pro getting information from Pablo Hidalgo, which is like Franklin Roosevelt getting information from, I don't know, Joseph Goebbels. Bullshit, okay. There's something happening at Lucasfilm. There's a cone of silence. I'm going to be honest. Encrypted emails are happening, so no one who can't read, who aren't supposed to read it, can read it. So something is going on. There are big names about ready to be let go, okay? And we don't know who they are. I'm not going to put names up there, but you guys know my opinion and the names we were told about. They're not that big. They're not that big to have encrypted emails about that, okay? Well, one of them is. That's it. One of them is that we know for sure. Anyway, just be patient. Look to Qui-Gon. Look to Yoda. Look to Luke as he's training his young apprentice Jedi. And just be. I mean, crying out loud, you want to be really patient. Look to Han Solo when Leia's being a pain in the ass. I mean, come on. And she was only doing what any other woman would do. He's so beautiful, I don't know what to do. Anyway, that's just me being weird. There's shit going down at Lucasfilm. And what we have to do is, again, be patient, like Qui-Gon, like Yoda, and like Luke, and like Han Solo with Leia, and just be, okay, accept what we know right now is what we know, because there is a circle of silence and we're not allowed to find out what's going on.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
The fleet has moved out of light speed and we're preparing to...
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral. Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
You will find that it is you who are mistaken about a great many things.
Okay, so what's going on is I think YouTube Land is being manipulated by this bitch. Everything that every big YouTuber is reporting about Favreau leaving, he hasn't left. His parking space is still at Lucasfilm. Okay. You know, and that's just physical. Okay. He's got shows in the vault. Okay. And there you go. I want to explain something. When you get a YouTuber who's brand new, who wasn't fighting with Pablo and Freddie Prinze Jr. and Matt Martin and Pablo's ugly, really ugly wife, Chrissy, back in 2018 and later, showing up and saying, well, Pablo's the most honest person I've ever met, you got a problem. Because the Favreau's leaving shit comes from that side. This is Kathleen Kennedy bullshit. Okay, I'm going to give you the straight skinny. This is the stuff you need to hear. Okay, we need to support Jon Favreau. He is still there. He is still fighting for Star Wars. And let's get into it. So, he was told by finance, Disney finance, that if Ahsoka doesn't break records or blow people's socks off, that they're not going to get a second season. And the second season would literally probably reset the timeline to, I think, the EU, to Malgus and Bane and Revan, la-di-da, blah, 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 blah. Ahsoka apparently was going off on a Sith artifact hunt through time. Okay. In the world between worlds. And we need that. If you want Disney to fix what they broke, you need to support Ahsoka. You need to sit your ass in front of the TV every Wednesday when it drops and watch and have fun. Okay. And here's how you do it. You don't watch the Black Pills. I don't even care about looking at friends of mine saying, you're being unreasonable. You're acting like a 12-year-old spoiled girl. Stop it. They're trying to fix what they broke. And you obviously don't understand how that works. It is that poof, it's gone. Which would make you feel better, but the people that kind of liked what you hated would be pissed off. Okay. This is not how you make things happen. And it works and it goes forward. It's incremental. Okay. This is incremental. So slow your roll, shut the fuck up, enjoy it. And oh, by the way, the same people liked Andor. The woke dykes, carpet muncher bitches, they like that shit. Well, it's adult. They filmed it on they went to London to film it. I've been there. I wanted to go to Coruscant. Assholes. Okay, so I didn't like it. And it was boring. And I'm sorry, but lesbians are disgusting. And should be... No, I don't want to say it. Anyway. You have to support Jon Favreau. You have to. Shut the fuck up. And support him. Okay? That's not hard to do. You watch stuff he puts out, and you like it, or you like some, and you have criticisms of other things, but you don't go out of your way like Ryan Connell and the rest of them and slay all of it. Okay, that's not how you do things. We're adults. This is a good man. He is one of us. Okay, he is one of us. And every one of you so-called Star Wars fans should understand, we have to support Ahsoka. We fucking have to support Ahsoka. Okay? I want every one of you to get a Disney Plus subscription just for the 8 weeks it's on. That's all you got to do. That's 2 months. All right? But do it, because this is how we fix what's broken. It's up to us. And honestly, when I look at Geeks and Gamers, Drunk 3PO, you know, the rest of them, they don't care about fixing what's broken. They don't. They're nihilists. They're not Star Wars fans. If they were, they'd be like, okay, you know, gonna see what else is happening. At least Star Wars Theory is honest enough to say he's going to watch it because he loves Star Wars. These guys, they love money. That's it. And they're using their subscribers to enrich themselves because they can't get jobs otherwise. Think about that too. Some of them should be gas station attendants. And they're telling you what to think. Okay? And you're giving them money. I want you to think about that. There's not a lot of integrity here. All right? I'm being brutally honest. Because I love this man. Steph, signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.